watching this video for the first time, please subscribe our channel and do not forget to press bell icon so that you will get notified with any future videos which will be uploaded in our channel. Today we are going to discuss about auxiliary boiler. So I will give you the basic information about auxiliary boiler. What are all the mountings, what are all the fittings, and what are all the safeties in boilers. Everything I will try to show you as a video, and I will explain you the function of those mountings and fittings. Please watch this video completely so that you don't miss any point which will be explained in between the video. So let's go check the video. And also, this auxiliary boiler is used when the ship is sailing at slow steam, when the vessel speed is less and the steam produced by the exhaust gas boiler is not enough for the demand which is onboard ship. So we use this auxiliary boiler to cope up the steam demand onboard ship during slow speeding of sailing. So okay, now we are standing on top of the boiler platform. So this is your exhaust gas pipe of your boiler, and you can see this is your temperature sensor of your exhaust gas, and you can see this is your main steam stop valve. This is the main steam stop valve, and you can see over here, you can see all small valves, 1, 2, 3. So all these three valves, one will be your vent valve and other will be your valve which goes to your sampling point. The other will be the valve which goes to your pressure gauge. And you can see here, these are all the two safety valves which is mounted on top of your boiler. So both the safety valve have different lifting pressure. Opening pressure will be different for both of these valves. And you can see both the valve outlet is joined with one pipe, and this pipe goes to the atmosphere. And also you can see a wire which is having a pulley and it goes down. This is for operating the safety valve away from your boiler, so that you don't need to come closer for activating this safety valve manually. So you can be away from the boiler. And I will show where is the operating lever. This is the rope which connects to your operating lever of safety valve. Okay, and then this is your circulating valve, the feed water circulating valve for the boiler, and it is connected to the exhaust gas boiler. And you can see here there is this valve, you call it as a feed water valve, and this is also a feed water valve, and this is scum valve. This is for the scum valve we use for top blowdown of your boiler. For doing the top side blowdown we use this valve. Water lines are coming from the feed water pump which feeds water for the boiler. And this valve you call it as a bypass valve or equalizing valve for the steam. So when the vessel is sailing, and during sailing, both EGB exhaust gas boiler is also under operation. And when the, as I said earlier, when the vessel is going low speed, and the steam demand will be higher than the production. So this boiler will be used during that time for steam production, and this is the line which equalizes the steam. So this is your steam equalizing valve, and these are all the components. These are all the mountings and fittings which we see on top of the boiler. Okay. Now we go to the second platform of the boiler. Okay, so this is your boiler gauge glass. we have two gear class for one boiler. This is a requirement for the boiler, because you need to have at least minimum two mode of boiler water indication. So this is one mode and this is the other mode. Apart from this, in this ship we can see the boiler water level remotely also. So this boiler water gauge, it's got two gauges. You can see the two valves over here. This is your steam line and this is your feed water line, and these two can be operated by remote drill also. You can see here there is one more wire going down, and I will also show where this wire leads to. The reason why they get the wire is to open close this steam and this water gauge glass from remotely without coming close to your steam gauge glass, water gauge glass. So we have two gauge glass, and you can see here, you can see here, this is your differential pressure transmitter, DPT transmitter. We call it as DP transmitter, and this is your water level sensor. This will indicate whether the boiler is having normal water or low water or low water or high water. This will give you alarm if there is any abnormal in your boiler water level. And these are the two valves that is connected to your differential pressure transmitter. So, okay. And you can see this is your support for your boiler. This support is to ensure to avoid any vibration. Because in sailing, this will avoid the boiler getting vibration. This is for your support. This is your support. And you can see a support over the other side also. That is your other support. Okay, so the second platform, I had given you all the information, and we go down. So this is your mud hole. You call it as a mud hole. When we during survey time we need to remove this. Inside there will be a cover. All the dirt, smell which is accumulated in bottom of the boiler. This is called as mud hole or hand hole, you can say. And this is your inspection glass. This is your inspection glass. Here you can see the glass, and when the boiler is firing, you can see the fire over here. From here you can see the boiler is firing properly or not. You can see the flame condition from here. Okay. And then you see a valve over here. This is your heating coil inlet valve for the boiler, and this is your heating coil outlet valve for the boiler. The reason for keeping the heating coil inlet and outlet for the boiler is, when the auxiliary boiler is not running, and to avoid the boiler water getting cooled, tap from economizer is given to the boiler, so that the heat water will ensure the boiler, actually boiler water, is kept hot. It is not kept cold. So that is to avoid cold corrosion to the fuel. This is the reason we have a heating coil in this boiler. Okay. This is your blowdown valve, bottom blowdown valve, you call it as. You have two valves over here. This is for additional safety, and you can see a hopper over here. This is your hopper, and the reason, this is actually your drain hopper, you can see here. And this drain is connected to your safety valve drain and your gauge glass, water gauge glass drain, everything. This gauge glass, drain is getting water from the water gauge glass drain, wind drain, and your safety valve drain, and your water gauge glass. So all these drains come to this area. So I told you, I showed the wire which comes from the water gauge glass. So that wire will be over here. So if you want to operate, if you want to open or close, you just need to remove and pull it. If you pull, you can open. Open for opening, this lever you have to use, and for closing, you have to use this lever. So same for both water gauge glass. You can see four valve handles for operating the steam valve and your water cycle. For operating it without going nearer to the gauge glass. Okay. So I showed you the wire which comes from the safety valve, and this is where it is connected to. So you have to turn it clockwise or anti-clockwise. You can see it is using here for safety valve. You open this way for opening and the other way for closing. So the reason why we need this operating remotely is to avoid any danger and to avoid operating the safety valve when the boiler is getting over pressurized. So to avoid any accidents, we operate the safety valve from here. Lift the safety valve and release the boiler pressure. So this is the idea for this is the reason why we kept the remote operating. But call it as remote operating of safety valve or emergency operation of your safety valve. Okay. This valve is your circulating water outlet valve. I had shown you the circulating water inlet valve in the top of our boiler. So this is your outlet valve. As you can see, vent valve over here, this is your drain valve. When we are doing any water wash of your boiler tubes, that the wash water will be taken out from this valve and it will go into your drain tank or bin wherever this line is connected. Okay. And you can see, this is your axillary burner chamber. You call it as actually burner chamber, and this is your primary fan, and this is your secondary fan, and this is your fuel oil valve regulating valve, and this is your fuel inlet for your boiler, and this is your emergency stop for your fuel oil to cut off the boiler firing, and this is your flame eye. We call this as flame eye, and this is your pilot burner, and here this is your rotary cup burner. This will be a rotary cup burner. In my next video I will explain you how to do maintenance for this rotary cup burner. And this is your flow meter. You can see the flow meter. This is the flow meter, and this panel is for operating the boiler, firing the boiler manually, manual firing panel, and you can have a lot of pressure transmitters and solenoid valves, and this operation of our actual boiler firing I will tell you in my next video. Just I want to show you what are all the parts, what are all the mounting, what are all the fittings which is incorporated in our boiler. So I would just want to convey only this information. And you can see this is your burner control panel, and you can see all the parameters over here in this panel. This is a touchscreen panel. You can see every parameter. You can see the steam pressure, water level, fuel oil flow, everything, and you can see the power on burner, whether it is in auto or stop. This is your reset button, all emergency stop over here, and you can see the running current of the motors, pump and everything. So this is the breaker for all your pumps and fans, whichever you are using for our boiler. And this is your boiler drum pressure indicating. You can see the boiler drum pressure from here. Okay, so these are all the information, I think this information which I have given to you regarding boiler must have given you some idea, basic idea about your auxiliary boiler. I believe like this video. Thanks for watching this video. If you like, please like, share, and do not forget to subscribe. Thanks for watching. Thanks.